given the week that your side have had, how nice is it to see the energy, the result, the performance of coming to a place like this, rocking, take away that, that crucial team?
Yeah, it was incredibly difficult for the boys today, to be honest. It's clear. I mean, we played two and a half days ago, if you want. Coming here, team in form, 6 wins, home wins on a bounce, great weather, everybody in a good mood. Actually, pretty much everything is prepared for another home win. The only group who wanted to avoid that were my players, and it was an outstanding football game, to be honest. First 15 minutes, we had to adapt slightly, a little bit, that's normal. Newcastle changed a little bit, put Drilton on the right side, left side, our right, and kicked the ball there, went for second balls. We struggled a bit, tried to adapt to it, did better. When the ball was on the ground, we were really good there already. I really liked how we played, how we put them, kept them quiet. Can't remember a lot of counter attacks. There was an offside goal they scored. That might be one of the second half. Yeah, the chance they had was offside as well. So honestly, in the circumstances, top class performance. Really happy.
How do you keep churning out performances like that? I mean, you made 4 changes today.
5.
5 changes, and the lads who came in were just as good as the ones that you left out.
Yeah, it's cool, then. Yeah, to be honest, it's that's the only reason why we are where we are. That's how it is. It's the only reason the boys buy completely in the situation. The boys that didn't come on today should have seen their faces on the bench when the final whistle. And we heard the final whistle. It's absolutely outstanding. We know that the group is exceptional, exceptionally talented, and has a really good character. And that's very helpful.
Neil, John, go.
That's got James Milner. I mean, I think it was his first Premier League start since the 2nd of January. But to come in and play like that in such a big game and having that, not as much football as I'm sure he would have liked, what's that say about him?
Yeah, outstanding. But he had it for sure another game. It was just Premier League start. Yeah, thank you very much. So he played in any other competitions, yeah. Millie is Millie, and it's incredibly important for us. And that's very important because people think we talk about dressing room or kind of this happening. Yes, it is helpful. He's very helpful there, especially with the manager who speaks, is no native speaker. Sorry. But on the pitch as well, and he played in a super game. Super game today. So, I don't want to take anything away from him, but I thought I liked Naby's performance as well a little bit. Hand on 6 and all this kind of that. So that worked out really well. The boys were on fire. We played football. We kept the ball in the right moments. We struggled around the second ball fights. We knew that before the game because there's no way I know at least to defend them 100%. It's always really tricky, 50-50 in between ball input. That's not cool to defend, but apart from that, I really loved the game, and James was a massive part of it.
Okay, gentlemen behind Keith, and then we'll go to Sam from Twitter.
Jürgen, you've achieved an awful lot in your career already, but how excited are you personally going into the last few weeks of the season with what's at stake for you?
Yeah, very excited, but not because the prospect of winning something, because I never understood that. It's like... let me say we have 5 points ahead in the league, for example, and then you have 4 games to play, and you're all the time people ask, oh, is he looking forward to it? No, you're just concerned about winning the next game. If somebody tells you it's done, then you can think about all the rest. So I'm not smart enough to try 2 things at the same time. So if we finish the game, and our analyst was in the dressing room, and I asked him, how's VAR playing? So, because they play at now as well, they were 2-1 down, changes, made a few changes, lineup. But so that's our life. We are excited. I love this football team, and we go in the next one and try to be as good as somehow possible. But that's it pretty much. It's a good situation. But for us, the number of games we still have to play are really, it's a lot. With or without the Champions League final, it's a lot. So, and we should better win everything because otherwise it could be tricky.
We've got the last last three, I think, Sam, Luke, and then Kiva to finish. But
how do you, when you make those big decisions about changing the team, obviously you have to, how do you make it? Because obviously you can't change everyone, you know, and some of them have to play every game.
No, look, obviously it's my job to make decisions. I don't have to do a lot of other things. So the thing is, for example, Kostas Tsimikas would have deserved to play as well. And Robbo could have had a break as well. But when you change one fullback and a centre half, and then with the other fullback, three changes the last line. So that's what I think. Then, okay, no. Don't do that. Let's do it like this. These kind of things. So, but the decisions are not that difficult because the boys are all in a good shape. So really, all in a good shape. And we had now Divo Origi with as well a little bit vomiting stuff like this, stomach problems. We had that before with Curtis and with Costa. So we have to make sure and be careful that it's not really going around. That's why he was not involved. It's hard in moments for the players not to play, but with the quality the boys offer, it's for me not that difficult.
Okay, Luke, Kiva, and then we'll finish.
Yeah, then James Milner made his debut 20 years ago.
Why were the people whistling a little bit when he had the ball with Hendo? I understand it, but what was it about Millie when he got the corner? And that's then people whistle or what?
He got applause.
He got applause as well.
They quite like James.
Oh, good. Yeah. I just want to ask, because I thought I heard a few.
No, you've met 20 years, he's 36. Have you met a fitter 36-year-old,
no,
more dedicated professional in any way you've worked?
No, but it would be interesting to look at Luka Modric. Is he not 36 as well? So, obviously, a good generation. it's difficult to be fitter than Emily, and he's a role model. I told him, I can tell the whole world, nothing what we did achieved in the last few years would have happened without James Milner. Easy as that, if he was on a pitch or not. It is because he set standards in a way not a lot of people can set standards, and that was extreme. That educated all of us.
finish with Kiva, then we'll come on.
Another James Milner question.
Great.
Yeah, I think we're all obsessed with him. What's the latest on his future?
Nothing, a million decides that. Nothing new.